at a certain point, my hands and arms were just completely numb.
This could be the end of the road for Noah Olsen's podium hope.
He rolled the shit out of himself. He's gonna fuck with that one.
And this crowd has just come alive as simultaneously walking to their bars, Brent Bukowski and Matt Fraser. Three event wins in his first 3 years, four this weekend for Matt Fraser. You've been asking for it all weekend. Where's the Catron we saw in 2015 and 2016? We see her again at event number 12.
Catron Davisdotter picking up the win.
Katie Thorsdotter to second. Sarah Sigmundsdotter right behind, but it's Carl Webb.
That's not right. She was in the 72.
Something is amiss here, and it could have major implications.
Carl Webb decided not to do all the reps. It's faster if you don't.
Yeah, my judge and I had some miscommunication. He called me to go, and I did three rep shot, and I thought it looked funny because I was like looking ahead, and I was like, oh, looks like I've got one more square, but this guy's like, go, go, go. So I'm like, all right, I'll go. And he like just yells out, shit, and she like waves her arm over me, and I'm like, I've like just died a little bit in this workout. I'm on the other side, just like, and I'm like, what? If someone doesn't do the reps properly, that's totally out of my control. I do not care. Boz and everyone are part of the team that decides on what happens with that type of call. They're the professionals. They deal with it.
And what they're going to have to do is they're going to have to go back and count the total number of repetitions to confirm that she did 75 total overhead squats.
Everyone's picked up a stink because they're like, nah, you didn't do all the reps. And like, it's no big deal. They just add a couple of seconds. I'll get a couple of places lower. That's it. That's it. But everyone's making a big deal about it. It's the last day. They're so f***ing tired because they've been judging like non-stop. And like, yes, they're professional and you'd like to say that everything's done perfectly, but they're human beings and there is such thing as human error. I make mistakes all the time and that's all I saw it as. I'm like, oh f***, it's a bit unfortunate. Like, it'd be good if I did the three and got a time or whatever. But if this is what it is, like, you know, like, what are we going to do about it, you know? Just figure out how to fix it, give me an appropriate time, move on.
So what happened is he got 72 reps off the finish. So I went back and looked at your last set finish, 69 to 72.
Sure.
From the time you stood that one up, walked forward, did 3 to 6 sets.
Yep.
Because like, that's the only fair way we can
sure.
Off that.
That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, good one.
Spectacles, because the athletes will make the memories out of the events. They're final heat. Real male miter on there. 1-2. Who's gonna come in first?
As the weekend wore on, I never counted myself out. But about halfway through Sunday, it became very apparent that he was still in class of his own. He's still just better than everyone. And it's pretty cool to try to test yourself against the best, you know, the best CrossFit athlete on the planet.
I see no one in the crowd. I don't hear the music. Like, it's just like tunnel vision, focusing on the stuff that I have to focus on.
Matt Fraser is about to become the second man to win multiple CrossFit Games championships.
I was like jumping through the roof of like, so I just hit the minimum work requirement. You're gold. But still, it's like minimum work requirement, or you're not on the podium. You're doing this all week, and then it comes down to 13 deadlifts and 13 handstand push-ups. Like,
front of me by milliseconds, and I was just so frustrated at myself that I had let that be the outcome. I've let Shane down.
Tia, come over. We did the whole high five at the end of it, and all she said was, I didn't make it. It just sunk in again, but this time I wasn't gutted for myself. I was sorry for her. So then I had to get out of there because, I don't know, I just felt like, what can I do? So I ended up walking up the top of the stadium. And as I got to the top, I just sort of had a couple of big, deep breaths going. And I just remember this. I'm just gazing at the big screen. Kai was 17, was 8.
I gave her a hug and I told her she looked very impressive. She just looked at the picture. I don't think I did it. That's all she said. Right now, I'm standing up here, I can't believe it, and I'm just like, it's done. You know, you just get this massive emotional dump, and there was not one single part of me at that point in time that was disappointed at all. I was so happy.
So I'm gone through the phone, and I look up at the points, knowing that 6-point difference. And at this stage, Castro's called Kara and Tira.
Your 2017 Fittest Woman Alive is from Australia! Your 2017 Rebound Crossing Games champion is...
Driving to a school park.